to AWPC Wild Media. I'm Rukshi. Today, we are going to talk to a very famous, prominent photographer in Sri Lanka. That is Prasad Hapuarachchi. Let's go in and see what he has to say. AWPC Wild Media. I'm Rukshi, and today I'm with a very famous, prominent wildlife photographer from Sri Lanka. That is none other than Prasad Hapuarachchi. Hello, Prasad. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you very much.
So how are you keeping these days?
I'm doing good, really good. I mean, a couple of days we were inside one of the expeditions, and we have planned another few more expeditions in future.
Wow.
If this COVID-19 pandemic not disturb us very much, we will be able to cover up some more expeditions in very near future.
That's nice. So as a start, Prasad, so I have a few questions for you today. Okay. Are you ready to answer those?
Of course, yes.
Oh, nice. So Prasad, as a start, I would love to know about you. Who are you?
Rukshi, as you told earlier, well, my name is Prasad Hapuarachchi. And I'm a wildlife photographer, then that's my hobby and meditation. Apart from that, I'm into many conservation projects. And I'm a businessman. And also, I'm a family man, having three kids as well. Yes.
And about the wife?
Well, yes, she's a school principal.
Okay.
She's attached to the government, yes, government school.
Lovely. So, Prasad, your second question is, how did you get into wildlife photography?
Since my childhood, I am very much interested in gadgets, especially for cameras and other stuff. And also to the natural habitat of the wildlife as well. So since I was very much into photography, I thought wildlife and nature is my passion and I should go with that.
Okay.
Because I am specialized in macro photography as well as wildlife photography. So apart from other segments in photography like commercial, model or whatever, this is the most interesting part in photography for me. So I thought I will go with this.
Oh, nice. So this camera is also one of your favorite gadgets you love?
Yes.
Okay.
Actually, that is my buddy. Wherever I go, I used to take this camera with me. Normally, I used to say, even if I go out without my pant, but not with my without my camera.
Gosh.
That is how I explain it.
Please, not without your pants anyway. Okay. So tell me, AWPC, Asian Wildlife Photographers Club, how do you connect? What is your connection there?
Actually, Tushar Palyaguru, he is one of the directors for AWPC now. And he's the one who have been introduced me to Dale. And Dale phoned me and they have appointed me as the country representative. And at the same time, they have appointed me as one of the directors for Sri Lankan AWPC. AWPC SL, yes.
Wow. So it's an honor to me to sit with the AWPC representative from Sri Lanka. Thank you, Prasad, for being here with us today.
You're welcome.
And the next question. Ready?
Yes.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm perfectly all right.
Okay. So, Prasad, tell me, when shooting, what are the equipment you use? What are the equipment you take with you?
Mostly, I carry my 800 tele lens. And apart from that, I take a wide angle lens as well.
Okay.
So, all the photographers, they know when the frame is so close, it's with details, but when you take a wide angle shot, there is a story, right? Ooh. So when we are in the expeditions, we take wide angle shots as well as the zoom shots, which gives more details about the species that we are photographing. So okay. both the lenses, like wide angle lens along with the extra camera, and my tele lens with another camera, I used to carry those two together.
Okay, so this is the first time for me to know, like, wide angle means a story.
Of course. Lovely. yes.
So what is your specialty in wildlife photography? Is it mammals or any other species that you like, birds? What is it?
When you consider about a wildlife photographer, you can't say whether it's mammals or birds or whatsoever.
Okay.
Wildlife photographer is a person who photographs every natural habitat of every species. But rather than other stuff, I'm very much into bird photography. The thing is, it's really challenging, not like the other species. Like you can take elephants, leopards, sloth bears.
We see many of the photographs.
Because elephants, it's easy for you to photograph.
Okay.
Though it's a little rare, not like the other species, but you can take a shot immediately.
Yeah.
When it comes to bird photography, that's really challenging because the frame is, when you frame the picture, the bird is very small species, and to find the bird is another task. So there are so many things inside birding photography, and it's really challenging. So I really love that.
And you need to have a lot of patience, I guess.
Of course, yes. Sometimes we used to spend hours and hours to take one single shot of a bird. And actually, to take one shot of an owl, I have been to New Aurelia for 4 times. And only in the 4th time, I was able to make a satisfiable shot at that time. So that is how the photography is, especially the wildlife photography.
And then finally, you were satisfied.
Of course, yes. Okay. Until I get myself satisfied, I used to recce, find the bird, shoot, again going. It's like that. There is a saying called, wildlife photographer never get satisfied. We keep on shooting the same bird again and again, because you know why? You can't see the same stances, same positions, same posing in every picture, right? It's every time it's different. Lighting is different, environment is different, birds' angles are different. So every picture is a new picture. So we keep on clicking. That's what we do.
Okay, nice. Okay, Prasad. So how many birds can we see in Sri Lanka? And can you tell us a bit more about how important Sri Lanka is when it comes to bird photography?
Sri Lanka is a biodiversity hotspot. And you have many species to photograph. When you consider about birds, in Sri Lanka, you can see around 460 birds. 460. Out of that, yes.
Okay.
34 birds are endemic.
Okay.
You can see only in Sri Lanka.
Okay.
And more than 200 species are breeding residents, and all the others are migrants. So this is a treasure land, you know, for a wildlife photographer. It's a treasure land here.
It's a paradise.
It is a paradise.
And they call it, right? Sri Lanka, the bird's paradise.
Yes, yeah. Paradise.
Okay. Nice. So you have published the most number of bird photographs in Sri Lanka as a single person.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So how many birds have you photographed so far?
I have photographed more than 250 species. Out of that, over 200 pictures has been published so far. There are some recorded shots. I mean, I have seen the bird, I have taken the picture.
Okay.
But those are, I don't feel like those are in a publishable manner. Okay. So I have not published.
Okay.
But I have seen more than 250 species.
Out of 460?
Yes. And I have photographed.
Okay.
Out of that, more than 200 species I have published.
So you're lucky. So for how long has this been your...
This is like almost the first bird's picture that I published before 12 years ago. And since that day onwards, I keep on collecting the bird's pictures and publishing it in the same album.
Okay.
Because now, actually, I stay in a very outskirt of Colombo, where so many marshy lands around. Inside my garden, I have photographed more than 38 species, bird species.
Wow.
That is, I love where I live.
That's nice. Okay. Now tell me, what is your favorite bird? I know I'm unfair by you, but what is your favorite bird and why?
I can't tell you exactly what bird is my favorite bird. But out of those birds, I like the blue magpie.
Okay.
Because of the color contrast, the beauty, and its endemic, iconic bird for Sri Lanka. I really love that bird.
By the way, Prasad, I was actually waiting to ask this question from you, right?
Mm-hmm.
What is the most unforgettable experience you have as a wildlife photographer?
Not very recently, a couple of years back, I was in Yala.
Uh-huh.
And we were having, we camp inside.
Mm-hmm.
That camping site is not a luxury camping site,
okay.
Actually. So I love to be those places because I am with the nature,
mm-hmm.
Nothing else. And we used to sleep on our, we used to keep our camera bags,
mm-hmm.
And we used to sleep on, we as a pillow, we used those camera bags. And there is a small, like, small, it's not a wall actually, around 3 feet tall.
Okay.
I used to, most of the time, once I get up, I used to sit on that and talk to the other people until they give me my bed tea.
Okay.
That time, when I sit on that, I saw some leopard paws just outside the wall. And not even half an hour ago, a fresh leopard paws. The truck has gone to somewhere else, towards the jungle.
Okay.
So I called the tracker and told him to look at this. And then the fellow was telling me, sir, this leopard has walked from here either half an hour or to 45 minutes ago. So close. I don't know whether it licked our faces, we really do not know. You know, after expedition is so tired, we sleep like dead bodies, we don't know what happens. And for the wind, all the lanterns has been off and we could not see anything over there. And leopard has actually gone, that was around 6:15, somewhere around that, by 5:30.
Gosh.
It has crossed those lines and walk towards the jungle.
Okay.
That was an unforgettable memory for me, yes.
Okay, wow. Anyway, do you have any photographs from that expedition?
Yes, I do have. I have many photographs, yes.
Okay, lovely. And I saw that you were on an expedition 2 weeks ago, right?
Yes.
You organized something. And
yeah.
How often do you go to the wild? And this week also, like in few days,
yes.
You are again on an expedition to the wild. How often do you go to the wild?
If I be honest with you, I rather love to stay inside the jungle rather than in my office, right?
Okay.
That gives me a real cool feeling. I can't explain it in my own words,
mm-hmm.
But every wildlife photographer who are into serious expeditions, they know what I'm telling. That is, actually, it's like a meditation, right? You don't get any calls, no any other burdens, you are free. Just
is it because you don't have signals or do
you usually switch off
your phone?
No, we don't get signals inside the parks.
Okay.
And I really love that part. No signals, no communication with the outside.
Okay.
So once we are in, as I told you, it's like a meditation to me. So I love to be inside the jungles, do more expeditions, take more photographs and make my album bigger and bigger every day. So normally, we used at least once a month, we are in expedition. But these couple of days, we planned a little more expedition since it's the birding season here in Sri Lanka.
Okay.
So
is it because of the weather? And
yes, it's a migrant season actually, starting from September till end of March.
Oh, okay.
It's the migrant season of the birds. So it is the high time for us to be in the wild, right?
Yeah.
So we have planned a couple of expeditions, back to back there are some expeditions.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Even coming, tomorrow night I'm leaving to Boondele and Nyala, I'll be there for another 3 nights. So that is how.
This comes to my next question. What is your favorite destination? I saw Boondele last time also. What is your favorite destination and why is it your favorite?
I really love to be at Yala and Vilpattu.
Uh-huh.
Vilpattu is really beautiful.
Okay.
It's the nature of Vilpattu is amazing, right? You can see different sceneries inside Vilpattu. And Yala, the leopard density is very high. Normally, for every square kilometer, you have the chance of seeing a leopard, right?
Wow.
Yes. And Vilpattu, it's really green. The birds and the other species look very beautiful with the green background. So when it comes to photography, yes, Vilpattu is much more better comparable to Yala. But again, when it comes to other species like leopards, pictures and other stuff, again, Yala also another good location. So I love to be in Yala and Vilpattu both.
You make me fall in love with wildlife photography, Prasad.
Very good.
Should definitely join you sometime.
Of course, why not?
Okay. So how do you feel being a wildlife photographer in Sri Lanka?
If you consider with the economical factor, you can't earn out of these pictures in Sri Lanka because there is no big demand in Sri Lanka. But again, you can sell those pictures for a calendar or book cover or some other stuff and earn some sort of money. But you can't make your living with that. But out of Sri Lanka, if you take Europe and all, wildlife photographers are, they're very rich because they can sell their photograph for a big amount of money.
Yeah.
Not in Sri Lanka. There is no market in Sri Lanka. I don't know, because of most of the people, they are very much attached to this wildlife habitat and all other stuff.
Okay.
In Sri Lanka,
can't we do something about that?
Well, we can sell it to the outside, out of Sri Lanka. We can sell through stock photography or any other platforms. Even AWPC is going to have their own e-commerce platform. We can sell through that as well in future. So we are working towards that.
Okay.
And I think it will create a good market inside Sri Lanka for the Sri Lankan photographers to sell their stuff to. Out of Sri Lanka,
definitely.
Yes,
yeah,
yes, for a good amount of money, yes.
Yes. So Prasad, what do you do to inspire emerging wildlife photographers in Sri Lanka? Because I've seen a few of your initiatives. What do you do? Can you tell us a bit more about it?
The reason why I am conducting workshops, actually I conduct workshops.
Okay.
And I teach them about wildlife photography.
Okay.
The main reason for that is I want these people to step into conservations. If we did not protect these natural treasures to the future generations, very soon we are going to lose one treasure land in the world, right?
Agree. Yeah.
Because even now, we have actually destroyed many forest densities, right? Like if you take the human beings, we are the last people who have come to this ecosystem, right? If you take from Homo erectus, likewise the evolution comes up to Homo sapiens sapiens. Homo sapiens sapiens is the last species who came to this ecosystem.
Yeah.
And he have no rights to destroy it. Because we are the junior people, we are not the seniors to the system, right?
And even we are facing the repercussions because we have...
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And deforestation is a big issue in Sri Lanka. Actually, to have the... to breathe enough oxygen for the Sri Lankan population, the forest density has to be at least 25% to 30%, which has been gone down drastically, right? So, in my point of view, deforestation I consider as a criminal offense. It's more or less step by step they are killing the human beings as well.
Yeah.
If you are losing oxygen, if you can't breathe, right?
How can we
so
live?
We can't live.
Yeah.
So doing deforestation, what these people do is, in another way, they are doing a criminal activity. It's a crime actually. So knowing this fact, I always teach people to protect the environment, to protect the wildlife and to conserve it. To do that, people should understand the value of it, right? If I tell you, yes, we have to stop deforestation, it doesn't feel you, right? But if I teach you how to see, if I teach you how to see the beauty of the nature, then you start enjoying.
Yeah,
once you start enjoying, you start protecting it.
Agreed.
So this is what I do. So I'll keep on teaching the wildlife photography to the people who are willing to know about it, to conserve these treasure island, to conserve these things and to preserve this treasure island as it is.
Here's another favorite question of mine to you, Prasad. Who is that one photographer or photographers, it can be, that inspired you most? And tell us why.
If I tell you honestly, he's not a photographer.
Okay. Okay.
He is a documentary maker, none other than world famous David Attenborough, right? He is the one who inspired me for wildlife photography, because I have seen so many recordings of his wildlife, especially like Sahara and some other episodes in BBC and National Geographic. The frames and the details of the natural habitat of these wildlife species, it really make me interested to study those stuff and to be a wildlife photographer. So he's the person who really inspired me. Even today, he's the one who is still inspiring me.
Okay, that's nice. Lovely. So do you have any tips for the ones who want to become a wildlife photographer?
If you take from analog era to digital era, right? I started photography when it was in the analog era, right? We shoot from slides. Now the technology has evolved and it comes to the digital era, right? So most of the people, they do not know the basics of photography. They take a camera, put it on a program mode, and they keep shooting and they think they are photographers.
And even sometimes they edit, right?
Yeah, they edit. And that is not a fact to consider him as a photographer.
Okay.
He's a cameraman. He's basically a cameraman. He just operates the camera, that's it. To be a photographer, you should get to know all these basics. The shutter speed, the aperture, the ISO, how you are changing those stuff time to time, because when it comes to wildlife photography, it's really challenging.
Yeah.
One forest density, the color temperature of one forest density is totally different
to another.
To another. So you need to know how to change those three things and to have the best exposure what you want, right? It has to, since it is wildlife and nature, the natural color has to be recorded as it is. You can't edit it. The green has to be green.
And nature has its own colors.
Of course,
those colors are just mind-blowing.
Yes. Yeah. So most of the photographers I have seen, they do not know actually to set up their white balance. So the color tones are different. It can't be like that. So the first tip I'm telling to every person who is trying to step into wildlife photography, study photography first. Then master your gear, whatever the camera you are having, master it. Get to know more how to change settings, how to operate it. And then you have to start learning the habitat of wildlife species to be a wildlife photographer. Without knowing the habitat of these species, you can't take a good shot. You do not know what will be happening in the next.
You need to know what to expect, and that's why I see that you have a lot of books here. You read all these books.
Yes.
You have everything in it.
Yes, those are actually the guides. Some species, like when it comes to insects and other species, we really do not know. I can't memorize it and find the name. So I refer to those guides and find the what species it is. And even for birding, I can't keep all the 460 birds in my mind. So sometimes some birds I have never seen. So we have to refer to those guides and find what bird it is. Then we have to study what sort of habitat they have, in what sort of environment they wish to stay. Like if you take, for example, if you take Indian pitta, right? That bird is a migratory bird. Indian pitta.
Okay.
We call in Sinhala as avichya, right?
Okay.
Very beautiful bird.
Okay.
That bird, when it comes to Sri Lanka on the migrant season, it chooses one land, and it can be a one land, and every time it comes to that land only. Right? Every migrant season, that bird comes to that land. Even in my garden, there was Indian pitta in the migrant season, but last 2 years I didn't see it. Either the bird has been dead or maybe accident, or else its natural habitat has been changed. These three things can happen. But I know for sure nothing has changed in my garden, because it has been it has lived to the birds. Mm-hmm. There are many fruit trees in my garden. We never take anything for our we never eat all this stuff like bananas, mangoes, guavas. Everything has been lived to those birds and other species, because they can't buy, only we can buy those stuff. Mm-hmm. So we have to let them get feed and to live their lives in a peaceful way. So we have left those stuff to those species.
Nice. A lot of work to be done even behind the scenes, emotionally. Yes. And your attitude should be there, a lot of things. Mm.
And at the same time, maintaining a bird bath is another good thing. You can see a lot of birds afterwards, but it has to maintain in a perfect manner.
Okay, lovely. So Prasad, finally, tell me why a wildlife photographer should join AWPC.
AWPC is going to be one of the fastest growing wildlife community brands, connecting over 10,000 Asian wildlife photographers from over 30 Asian countries in 2022. So AWPC is giving exposure, recognition, opportunities, value to emerging and professional wildlife photographers. So I believe, as a Sri Lankan wildlife photographer, since there is no market in Sri Lanka, especially for wildlife photographers, and AWPC and as also as the AWPC country representative Sri Lanka, it's always good joining a brand like AWPC. Whereas it really, actually AWPC is targeting some conservation projects as well. And that is what exactly catch me to be for AWPC. And the platform that they are going to come up for emerging and professional wildlife photographers in Sri Lanka to sell their products, to sell their pictures to the outside, AWPC is going to come up with a good platform. So I think AWPC is the brand which is going to be very much popular in Asian region in coming future.